Match between the Iron Sheik and Sergeant Slaughter. You've got a crack at the former Marine prior to that out at the Cape Cod Coliseum.
You know, I'd give anything in the world to get my hands on him before the Sheik got his hands on him.
You're going to do it.
Because after the Sheik gets his hands on you, boy, or after I get my hands on you, ain't nobody going to want you anymore. We're going to make mincemeat out of you, boy. We're going to make dog meat out of you. We're going to beat you up so bad, and you're talking about combat boots in Vietnam. I never seen a soldier in my life while I was in Vietnam wear steel-toed combat boots, you idiot. It rains a lot there. You're a goof. You ain't got everything upstairs. But Cape Cod, wherever that is, well, I'll get there.
You know, I've got a good friend. Friend of mine who lives out there.
I don't care if your whole family lives there. I don't care if your mama lives there. I don't care if your daddy and your mama lives there together. I don't care if your mama lives with another man there. I want Sergeant Slaughter there. And I don't care if you bring your mama with you, Sergeant Slaughter. I'll slap her like a dog. And I don't care if you bring your daddy. I'll beat him like a dog. Now, see, I just don't care. You know what I mean?
I believe there's an attitude problem.
Now, bring your family with you.
Yes.
I believe you've got the problem.
I don't have
You any. Look like you got a problem. You're getting thin on the head. You're ugly. I don't like you. You got a bad, manners. You and Sarge might be kin. You both might be from Cape Cod. So just bring the whole family and line them up, because I'd like to slap about 15 or 20 of them plumb silly after I get through with you, Sergeant Slaughter.
Thank you very much, Dr. David Schultz, outspoken.
Cut out for you going against Rick Quickdraw McGraw.
Are you through talking?
I'm through.
You ready to shut your mouth and listen now?
It's all yours.
I like to went to sleep. You said out here with all this TV gaga, you can't get it out. It takes you 30 minutes to mention that man's name. Well, it don't take me that long. It don't take me that long to whoop nobody. It don't take me that long to knock a woman plumb down, face down on the ground. It don't take me that long to kick her in the mouth. It don't take me that long to whoop anybody. Because when I come to do business. I've always done business in Vancouver, B.C. Anytime they had somebody they had to get rid of, they called Dr. D. Write me a letter. Dr. D, please come up here. We got somebody that's acting bad. We want you to take care of him. I always come in. I took care of him. Everybody wanted to cry on my shoulder. Everybody wanted me to tote him around on my back. Everybody wanted me doing favors. Nobody wanted to do nothing for me. Now you got this little punk, first grade punk, man. You go down the street anywhere in Vancouver, in the back alleys, you can find punks like this every day. I see them. Canadian punks, what they are. They couldn't fight their way out of a wet paper sack, I think that's what they call it up there in Vancouver, B.C. And he's going to climb in the ring with me? Well, that's a joke. That's a joke. I've been laughing ever since I heard it. I like to went to sleep while you was talking about it. Sounds like to me it's going to be a night at the Freakers Ball, you know what I mean? You got them all running around, people with spears. You got people, big fat people. You got little skinny people. You got them all, but you got Dr. D coming. I always done it, but I want to tell you people of Vancouver one thing. Stay away from me. I don't want you to touch me. I don't want you to come near me. I don't want you to associate yourself with me at all. And I don't want you to be touching me like you just did. I don't want nothing to do with you. I'm going to come do my thing, then I'm going to get back on the quickest airplane I can, get back to the United States of America, because I'm fed up to here with Canada and everything about it, if you know what I'm saying. Do you understand what I'm saying? Dummy, can you talk?
I can talk.
Well, why don't you say something instead of standing out here on national TV like Heidi Doody or somebody, waiting for somebody to stick their hand up your back and make you talk? I don't guess you can talk.
Get
I don't guess you ever had a woman either,
at
have you?
Pacific Coliseum box office.
That's where I've got
That's
you.
Monday,
I've had a woman.
November
I've put
the 5th,
man, and I slapped
8 p.m.
a woman.
We'll see
and
you
I'm
there.
I'm thinking about slapping you.
The redneck Schultz, as the fans call you. You see something like this happen, it's got to be upsetting to you.
It don't upset me at all, baby. Let me tell you, I think it's great. You know what I mean? If you're going to go on the hunt, you got to be able to run with the big boys. If he can't run with the big boys, he should get out. He shouldn't come out here. Last time I was in San Francisco, I went downtown looking for a woman. You know what I mean? I wanted a woman. I couldn't find a woman. I found a lot of men that looked like women. Now, you, Hulk Hogan, you belong in San Francisco. What's wrong with you, Gene? I'm telling you like it is, baby. You belong in San Francisco. That's your kind of place. That's your kind of people, because you've never had a woman, baby. And now I'm challenging you. I'm challenging you, right?
I have that guy hanging around with you all the time. Now, this one right here,
This is an old 12-gauge.
If you don't mind, I don't want that pointed at me again. If you don't mind, please.
I told you, appreciate... I know my guns are not... Look here, Alfred Hayes, I can put you in line.
Stop it, wait a minute.
No, really. I just think you can go, you know, just... I mean, you know, it's no problem.
What's wrong with you? Why are you making me nervous?
I told both of you, the gun's not loaded, see?
Well, I mean, you never know when one is loaded.
See, look, I'll show you. Here. Whoa! You stupid idiot!
That is the first thing to do!
You're loaded. What's the matter? What's the matter with you? Don't even go holler at you, you stupid! Hey, wait a minute! Okay, all right, just cool. All right,
no problem.
Okay, no problem, just cool. All right, keep fine.
One of you loaded the gun.
No problem.
Tough to get a hold of these days, Dr. David Schultz.
You know, Bob Backlund comes out here running his mouth and talking about these young kids and everything, these young boys, all this here amateur wrestling stuff coming out here, going to help them and all that. That's all I've ever heard this boy do. And I hear you don't like women, Bob Backlund. I hear that. He does not like women.
He's a family man.
It don't make any difference if you're a family man or not. He was talking about Ivan Buskey love his kids, about him being a family man. What do you think we are? You think we're tramps? You think we're garbage in the street? We've never done nothing to you, boy. We've never come out here and run you down, tried to embarrass you, humiliate you in front of a TV camera. And you coming out here talking about the families. Well, baby, we're family men, too. We got families all over the United States.
Two or three of them.
That's right. We got them everywhere.
Gentlemen.
And we got young kids running around everywhere. That's right. Because of our religion. That's because of our belief.
We can afford it, too.
And you went and got Ivan Buskey, an old man. You want some experience to give experience.
I can't believe it.
Well, when you get out there, howdy doody, you bring everything you know with you, boy. Because I'm going to wrap these mamas around them howdy-doody ears, and I'm going to squeeze them, and this man's going to knock Ivan Buskey down, and he's going to sing that old song he sings all the time to Bob Backlund, which will be great. And I'm
Dr. David Schultz.
I'm not going to say nothing about what happened the last time when Roddy Piper and myself left the gardens, but some big goof was toted out. Now, you got Rocky Johnson and that Tony Atlas, that Ivy Buskey. Let me tell you, happy birthday, Tony Atlas. Happy birthday, because where I come from, and I'm going to remember where I come from, we tie people up on their birthday and we whoop them. We whoop them, we give them one lick for each year of their age. And that means you're going to have stripes all over your back, boy. And then I'm going to grab Rocky Johnson, and I'm going to pretend it's his birthday, and we're going to put straps on him, and we're going to hold Ivan Buskey and make him witness it, because I think he needs to see what it's all about.
Along with Dave Schultz, Dr. D.
Yes, that's it, baby. I guess you think I should go and hide again, because everybody's saying that big freak of nature is coming to St. Louis, and I've got a match with him. Well, I got something to tell you, big boy. I'm not going to lay down. I'm not going to lay down and let you walk over me. If he was here, I'd whoop him right now, baby.
Wait a minute.
Yeah, I'd whoop him right now. What you're talking about is some big idiotic goofball that ain't got a brain in his head, and what he's supposed to do, yeah.
Just a minute here. Just a minute. Andre the Giant.
Say, is this, Laura? I don't have to impress nobody because you just impressed yourself by coming out here making a complete fool out of yourself, telling everybody how you followed my career about the people that I have beat. And you know the people I have beat. And you come out here and tell people that you had to pay more money to get Bruiser Brody. That's right. Because I found out something about you, Laura. Nobody wants to be your tag team partner because you've got a disease, boy. I've checked on you. You have a disease, and they call it AIDS. I have checked on. Nobody wants that to do with you. And I've got another thing to tell you. You're right. I hit Bruiser Brody. I hit him with a stick. But you know why? He caught me holding his woman in my arms. Yeah, that's what he did. And he jumped me, and I taught him a lesson. Now, Lawler, I want to tell you something about your woman, about your wife and your girlfriend. The doctor might have had his hands all over her. Who knows? I don't have to impress nobody, big boy.
Okay.
If I had to pull this man off of you, baby, last Monday night, he would have killed you. He would have took your life right there, big boy. I had your life in these hands, Jerry Lawler, like the great film of God's up above, baby. I could have took your life just like that. It's a town all over.
We're going to hear about this myth all over the world, Lance Russell.
Meadowlands for the world's heavyweight title.
You know, when I came north, they told me there was a lot of people up here. They said there's a lot of Americans, true Americans up here. Well, there are not no Americans up here. There's not no true Americans. There's not no people that can stand up for their country, especially you, Hulk Hogan. I don't know who give you that name, boy, but where I come from, people like you that looks like you, we put them in an outhouse, we lock the door, and we feed them three times a day, and we don't let them be seen in public, if you know what I'm saying. What do you mean? Oh, just shut up a minute, will you? Your job is to hold this mic, baby. Don't be interrupting the doctor. Now, Hulk Hogan, you got to admit, a man with 23-inch arms and a head as big as yours and feet as long as yours has got to be classified a freak, has got to be classified as somebody not normal. I am normal. I am a true American. And when I get you in that Meadowlands, I'm going to hit you so hard, they'll catch you in California speeding, boy. And whenever they catch you, I'm going to be there, and I'm going to drive this hammer in your head, and you're going to lay down on that beach. And then when you get to walking, quit hitting my leg.
I'm sorry, I know you ain't got enough time.
Y'all come on in here. Sit down. You boys get over here at the table. Sit down here. We'll get something to eat. Y'all sit down right there. Just something to eat here.
Whoa! What in the world is wrong with you, woman? You move the table out there? What do you do that for? You out of your mind?
Damn, you know what those cost? What is this, the city dump? Huh? You didn't have time. You didn't have chance. Sit down. Sit down. Get something to eat. You ain't got time to do nothing. Boy, I... What is this?
It's pizza, David.
I can see it's pizza. I'm not a fool. You think you married a fool?
The kids
You're making
pizza.
A fool out of me, what you're doing on national TV. Hey, I'm sorry. I told the woman to have something to eat fixed here for us to eat. I don't know what's wrong with her. Get up and get us something to eat or something. Do something. Don't just sit there like a goof or something. What are you smiling at? I'll slap that smile off your face. Don't smile at me, boy. Don't you laugh either. I mean it. Well, you're going to eat or you're going to stand there and stare at it? Eat it. Eat it now. Here, eat another piece of bread. Here, you eat a piece of bread. Here, you want another one? I'm sorry, I told y'all you come over, I invite you for supper, they put this out here, this goop here. I don't know what's wrong with you. Are you plumb out of your mind? Are you out of your mind? I'm talking to you, girl.
I just was fixing a little supper for the kids.
These ain't kids, these are TV people when you're out.
I wasn't expecting them, David.
Well, I told you they was coming. Just go on, get out of here. I don't even want you out here. I shouldn't even let you come down here out of the bedroom anyway. What are you looking at? You got a problem? Get upstairs. I don't want you down here either. Boy, this is ridiculous. I ain't never seen nothing. I don't know. Anyway, like I said, I'm like you people out there, man. I got wives, I got kids, I got problems. Only thing I know how to take. What are you looking at?
Nothing.
Hand me that tea, boy. You ain't gonna drink it. I got problems. He's got problems. Oh! Get up! Get upstairs! When I get through, I'm gonna get you too. Get your brother too. I'm gonna get all of y'all. Hey, I tell you, I'm just upset, man. I don't know. I'm tired. I shouldn't invite you out here in the first place. It's a private home. Get your stuff up. Just get out, okay? Just get out. I'm tired of everything. I'm tired of the chicken and the pizza. Get out.
Yeah, y'all get on out of here. What's wrong with you? You crazy? Come out here and try to make a fool out of me. Get the camera out of here. Don't ever come back. I'm sick and tired of everybody and everything. Woman!